Hello, Internet! I'm John Kapora, managing editor of magic.tcgplayer.com, and these are the best-selling cards of the past week. Let's get into it! Before Iconic Masters, Thoughtscour hadn't been printed since 2014, and since it's a key part of a couple modern decks, demand for it is high. Now that there's a reprint, players can finally get their hands on this delve-enabling card. Lightning Strike's been near the top of our bestsellers since Ixalan came out, and the fact that it was in an invitation-winning Teemer Energy deck puts it over the top this week. Like an extreme version of Thoughtscour, Mishra's Bauble was in short supply and high demand, but thanks to its appearance in Modern Masters, now everyone can afford to play a 56-card deck. I don't know how big the margins are on uncommons, but if you can pick them up for close to nothing, they are remarkably easy to move. Kitesail Freebooter has been a reliable seller for months. Same with Unclaimed Territory. I will say that it helps that these cards are great in Modern too. You can definitely lump Merfolk Branchwalker in with these. It's a good tribal card, but its role in the new blue-green Merfolk Modern deck puts it over the top. Alright, I'm gonna come clean. I have no idea why Fairy Miscreant of all things is selling well. My guess is that players are banking on Rivals of Ixalan supporting either fairies or rogues, or people just really like the mono blue popper deck. I have no clue. I'm open to ideas. Kamena Speaker, like Merfolk Branchwalker, also plays a huge part in making the blue-green Merfolk deck competitive in Modern. Speaking of competitive in Modern, you can't shake a stick in that format without hitting an opt these days. However, the best-selling cards are pre-sales of the unstable basics. I expect these cards to be on top of things for a long, long time, so get on board with it.